Hi and welcome to the second episode of Just Code, Atari 8-bit. And this wasn't the planned episode, but I fooled around with this a bit and I thought that it will make a great video, so, well, at least a good one. Well, here's the code we're gonna run today, and it's based on this pseudocode from Wikipedia. It's the pseudocode for the Mandelbrot set. So we have to translate into Atari BASIC, and it looks like this. And I got some questions from people about the trap. Why? What do you need to trap, really? And it's this simple. You get an float overflow, so the program terminates otherwise. I can show that also later. So let's run this and see how slow it is. Not that quick, and since it's 192 rows to do, this will take a while. So let's start it up in Atari BASIC instead. Let's like load it here. And it's called Mandel 4 because it's the fourth attempt I did. And this is in Atari BASIC. Look, it's a lot slower than Turbo BASIC XL, which is a basic variant for the Atari 8-bit. I absolutely recommend that you try. It takes all your Atari BASIC programs unmodified and they run a lot quicker. So let's go back into Turbo BASIC. And now we're going to compile this. It comes with a compiler. So we start compiler.com. Here's our second disk drive, and there we have Mandel4.base. Now it's compiled, and we have to save it to drive 1. And it says CTB, as to say, let's compile Turbo BASIC. And we don't need to save it again, and now we have to reboot the machine. Or, wait, we can go back to those, we do that. And then there's a runtime environment we have to load. That's runtime.com. And now it gives an error because we haven't loaded any file yet. So let's load this CTB, Mandel4.CTB. And you see it's a lot quicker when we compile it. No surprise there, really. I decided to do 40 iterations. And since the graphics mode 11 I use only have one, I only have 16 colors, we use 15 of the colors over and over again. And now we're gonna run the three variants side by side. There's the compiled one to the left, it's the Turbo BASIC one in the middle, and it's the Atari BASIC to the right. And you see how slow the Atari BASIC is compared to the compiled one. It's not surprising, really. Atari BASIC is not that well optimized because they were rushed to get it made. Let's look at the program real quick. First, we use a trap so we don't get any errors. Then we have the graphics 11 command, and we have a for loop from 0 to 191, that's our rows, and then we have a 4x, and the y01 there is you translate the coordinates, our coordinate system on the screen to the complex one. You can read more about the Mandelbrot set on Wikipedia. I will put the link down in the description to this video. And it's the same for the x coordinate. And then we set our variables to zero there, and then we check our termination if we should terminate, and we check if the iteration, if it runs off to a higher number, then we have and then we check if we have done for the iteration. We set our flag b to 1, or we do the Mandelbrot calculation, and we e is iteration, so we add 1 to that, and then we start over. And if our termination, and if we should terminate, we go to 110, we calculate the color, and if our flag is set that we didn't terminate, we set our color to 0, or else we set the color to the C that we calculated earlier, and then we plot. Then we start over a trap in case we got trapped to get here. And here we have our Mandelbrot in all its glory. The top, you see that it's on its way. Times faster than in real time, because this video will be unbearable long otherwise. And I think I think it goes even 50 times faster than normal speed, because we're gonna want to get finished someday. So this video don't get at all too long. you see the Atari BASIC one is on its way, it's almost half done. And the compiled program is finished a long time ago, and even the Turbo BASIC one is also finished some time ago, and we're still waiting for Atari BASIC to do its thing. Not that surprising really, but you also had commercial programs that was written in Turbo BASIC. I guess they were compiled, but still, it's quite a nice BASIC. And the same guy also wrote GFA BASIC for the Atari ST later. Well, I think I'll leave you to look at this Mandelbrot rendition, and see you next time.